Please, God, tell me what's the matter with Daddy.
God, that's why I'm
here, Lord. Watch over him tonight. There's one about Clarence. He served as a man of action. With all due respect, ma'am, all Clarence has accomplished so far is to get George Bailey soaking wet. It's out of our hands now, Joe. Wait, please.
I didn't have time to get these stylish undergarments, you see. My wife gave me this for my last birthday. I passed it in it.
How'd you happen to fall in?
I didn't fall in. I jumped and saved George.
You what? Saved me?
Well, I did, didn't I? Didn't go through with it, did you?
Go through with what?
Suicide.
It's against the law to commit suicide around here.
Yes, it's against the law where I come from, too.
Where do you come from?
Heaven.
Very fuck.
I had that quickly. That's why I jumped in. I knew if I were drowning, you'd try and save me, and you see, you did. That's why I saved you. Your lips bleeding, George.
Yeah, well, I got a bust in the jaw in answer to a prayer a little bit ago.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm the answer to your prayer, George. That's why I was sent down.
How do you know my name?
I know all about you. I've watched you grow up from a little boy.
What are you, a mind reader or something?
Oh, no.
Well, then who are you?
Clarence Oddbody, AS2.
Oddbody, AS2. What is this, AS2?
Angel Second Class. Cheerio, my good man.
Brother, I wonder what martini put in those drinks.
Did you feel you to think of killing yourself for money? $8,000.
Now, how did you know that?
I'm your guardian angel. I know everything about you.
Well, you look sort of like the kind of angel I...
I have to win my wing. That's why I'm in second class.
Well, I don't know whether I like it very much being seen around with an angel without any wings.
Oh, I have to earn them, and you'll help me, won't you?
Sure,
I'll... By letting me help you.
Oh, yeah, well, only one way you can help me. You don't have to have 8,000 bucks on you.
Oh, no, no, no. We don't use money in heaven.
It comes in pretty handy, don't it?
Oh.
I guess I found it out a little late. I'm worth more dead than alive.
No, you mustn't say things like that. I'll never get my wings with that. You just don't know all you've done. If it hadn't been...
Oh, yeah, well, if it hadn't been for me, a lot of people would have been better off. My wife, my kids, and my friends. Look, fella, go up and haunt somebody else, will you?
No, you don't understand about
my... Shut up, will you?
It's going to be so easy. So you still think killing yourself would make everyone feel happy?
Oh, I don't know. I suppose it would have been better off if I had just never been born at all.
What did you say?
I said I wish I had never been born.
You mustn't say things like that. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now that's an idea. What do you think? Yes, that'll do it. All right. You've got your wish. You've never been born.
You don't have to make all the fuss about it.
What'd you say? You've never been born. You don't exist. No care in the world. No worries, no obligations, no $8,000 to get. No potter looking for you for sure.
Say something else than that, even.
Sure, you can hear out of it.
Well, that's the doggone thing I haven't heard out of this ear since I was a kid. Must have been that jump in the cold water.
Your lips stop bleeding too, George.
Oh, what do you know about that? Your lips are bleeding. Not bleeding. And it's not snowing up, hasn't it? What's happened here? Well, what I need is a couple of stiff drinks. How about you, Angel? You want a drink? As soon as these clothes of yours are dry.
Our clothes are dry.
Well, what do you know about that? That's so hard than I thought. Well, come on, get dressed. We'll stroll into town and... I'll stroll. You fly.
I can't fly. I haven't got my wings yet.
Well, come on, Gabriel.
Clarence!
Look, there's a place to sit. Go ahead, sit.
You just gonna order something?
Oh, hello, Nick. Where's Martini?
You want a Martini?
No, Martini, your boss. Where is he?
Hey, look, I'm the boss here. Now, do you want something or don't you?
Double bourbon, quick, huh?
Okay. What's yours?
Oh, I was just thinking. It's so long since I...
Hey, look here, mister. I'm standing here waiting for you to make up your mind.
That's a good man. I was just thinking of flaming rum punch. No, not cold enough for that, not nearly cold enough for that. Wait a minute. Got it. Mulled wine, heavy on cinnamon and lavender cloves. Off with you, me lefty, lefty.
Hey, look here, mister. We serve hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast. We don't need any characters given the place atmosphere. Is that clear? Or do I have to flick you my left for a convincer?
What is he talking about?
Look, Nick, just give him the thing some other time.
Okay.
That's weird. I've never seen Nick act like that before.
You'll see a lot of strange things from now on.
You know what, fella? You worry me, you know? Do you have a place to sleep?
No.
You don't, huh? Well, you got any money?
No.
Well, it's no wonder you jumped off that bridge.
I jumped off the bridge to save you, George.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, somebody just made it.
Made what?
Every time you hear a bell ring, it means that some angel just got wings.
So look, I think you better not mention getting your wings around here.
Why? Don't they believe in angels?
Yeah?
Then why should they be surprised when they see one?
He never grew up. He's, how old are you, anyway?
290. Next.
That's okay. You two jokers go. Through the door or out the window.
Look, Nick, what's wrong?
And that's another thing. Where'd you come off calling me Nick?
Well, Nick, that's your name.
That's got nothing to do with it. I don't know you from Adam's pet monkey. Hey, you, Rumpy, come here. Didn't I tell you to never come panhandling around here anymore?
Miss Gower, Miss Gower, it's George Bailey. Don't you know me?
No. No.
Throw him out.
Nick, isn't that Mr. Gower the druggist?
And you know what? That's another reason for me not to like him. That woman has spent 20 years in jail for poisoning some kid, and if you know him, you must be a jailbird yourself. Will you show these gentlemen to the door?
Sure, boss. This way, gentlemen.
Hey, get me! I'm giving out wings!
Hey, George.
You weren't there to stop Gower from putting that poison into those castles.
Well, what do you mean I wasn't there? Well, what are you, a hypnotist?
No, of course not.
Well, then why am I seeing all these strange things?
Because you were never born.
Well, if I wasn't born, who am I?
You're nobody. You have no identity.
What do you mean, no identity? My name's George Bailey.
There is no George Bailey. You have no papers, no cars, no driver's license, no insurance policy. They're not there either.
What?
Susan's pedals.
Just a minute here.
You see, George, you've been given a great gift. A chance to see what the world would be like without you.
This must be some funny dream I'm having. So long, mister, I'm going home.
Home? What home?
Now shut up! You're crazy, you know that? I must be seeing things here. You're crazy and it's driving me insane. I'm going home to see my wife and my kids, you understand that? And I'm going home alone.
How am I doing, Frankie? Thanks. No, Joe, I did not have a drink.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree.